Netflix, it is a hugely developed business at the moment. In the recent years, they have added a massive amount of subscribers and they are now having 160 million subscribers around the world. And they have put the AI, ML and data at the core of their business strategies. So everything they know about us is driven by data and the machine learning algorithms. Starting off in 1997, it allowed people to rent DVDs online. In 2007, it came out with its own streaming services and later it began competing directly with TV networks and cable for original content. As of now, Netflix is the world's largest online TV streaming service. But how it happens? What does Netflix do that its competitors cannot? The answer is ML, AI and Big Data Analytics. Now what we are going to do is, we will discuss the use cases and applications of data science or ML at Netflix. Then we will discuss how this some of the use cases benefit the Netflix. Use cases. Movie recommendations. This is perhaps the most well-known feature of a Netflix. Netflix uses the watching history of other users with similar tastes to recommend what you may be most interested in watching next so that you stay engaged and continue your monthly subscription for more. Location scouting for movie production. Using data to help decide on where and when best to shoot a movie set given constraints of scheduling, budget and production scene requirements. Notice, this is more of a data science optimization problem rather than a machine learning model that makes predictions based on past data. Auto generation and personalization of thumbnails. Using thousands of video frames from an existing movie or show acts as a starting point for thumbnail generation. Netflix annotates these images, then ranks each image in an effort to identify which thumbnails have the highest likelihood of resulting in your click. These calculations are based on what others who are similar to you have clicked on. One finding could be that users who like certain actors or movie genres are more likely to click thumbnails with certain actors or image attributes. Movie editing. In post-production, when quality control checks has failed in the past, we need to check it manually. To predict when a manual check is most beneficial, we can use historical data. Otherwise, it will become very time intensive and laborious process. Streaming quality. Netflix uses fast streaming data to predict bandwidth usage to decide when to catch regional services for faster load times during peak demand. Now that we discussed the use cases, let's discuss how these use cases benefited the Netflix. Movie recommendations. Here the problem is that Netflix has a huge collection of content that is constantly changing and can be overwhelming for a user to consume. Users don't want to be frustrated in finding content relevant to their interest. To solve this problem, recommendation systems are used. Some benefits of using this include increase or maintain viewership in terms of minutes consumed, increase in number of titles explored, frequency of logging back in, exceeding whichever minimum threshold that the company determines is a success metric. Overall increase in monthly subscription loyalty, decrease in subscriber cancellations. Personalized image thumbnail or artwork. Personalized thumbnails are a subset to the movie recommendations. Given that movie recommendations are provided to the user, now how do we best present that movie recommendation to the user in a way that maximizes viewership and monthly subscriber loyalty? Well, one way to provide that recommendation is through an image thumbnail. But what kind of thumbnail do we provide? And how important is the thumbnail? Do we have data for that? Using the movie's original art as the only thumbnail, user for every single person, most likely won't yield the highest click rates. The business is likely leaving clicks on the table. So, this is a really interesting problem with the image thumbnail, which can have a huge impact on the likelihood that someone will click on a video and watch. To solve this problem, they came up with the thumbnail personalization. This is a data-driven personalization feature that sits on the top of the movie recommendation engine. Since Netflix has a data on clicking behavior of other people with similar interests, it is a reasonable hypothesis to guess that if other people with similar interest and watch history had a high click-through rate on a certain thumbnail, then it is likely that this image thumbnail will perform well on a new person who hasn't yet been recommended this movie or thumbnail. The personalized thumbnail will take into consideration of other movies which are being recommended at the same time and what those image recommendations are. Let's say Netflix is recommending two different Spider-Man movies to a user side by side, and they both have Spider-Man facing the camera mask off. One is Tobey Maguire and other is Andrew Garfield. Wouldn't be weird for the user to see both portraits of Maguire and Garfield as a Spider-Man with their mask off side by side? One image thumbnail could work well in isolation, but that may not be good enough when a page of dozen thumbnails shows up. If they are all optimized to look the same way, then as a group, each one may seem less compelling. So looking at each thumbnail together with what else is being presented will be important. So Netflix has a ton of data on each of its customers, from videos watched to images clicked. That's it for the video, guys. If you like this video, please do like, share, comment and subscribe.